We've got about 5 minutes left.
Getting good now.
Just a quick one. How do you learn different accents?
The ones behind you come though.
I can't do accents.
You're doing an American accent now.
Fair enough.
He does good American, eh?
That's true. West Coast Canadians are like East Coast Americans. Yeah, it was it.
Accents and dialects are really, it's some of the hardest stuff along with physical stuff for some actors. Some people, it's a knack. You can do it or you can't. It comes to you easily or it doesn't. Some people study really, really hard for it. Actually, New Zealand.
Oh.
Why did I go there?
Because I want to go there. I want to live in New Zealand. It's pretty.
But, the theater universities here, the theater programs there, you can't graduate until you've learned to do an American accent.
We were getting too much work off of Hercules and Cena. They want you to be able to do that now. They train you in it. They actually train you in it.
It helps to pick up an accent if you can actually do a few words in that language. But again, there's no quick and easy way to do it. Either you have the knack or you don't. When I'm doing audiobooks, I do a lot of audiobooks. One of the worst things I ever had was a scene where I'm playing a Japanese-American assassin who's, "Hello? Tell him you're busy."
"I told you never to call me in the middle of a panel."
So I've got this Japanese-American assassin, and he's got two women he's been having affairs with in the other room, and they start talking, discussing their relationship with him. One is a Japanese woman and the other is an Israeli woman. I'm the reader.
You gotta do all of that.
So in addition to making the changes so it's apparent that the speaker is female as opposed to male, and you can't really do a full-on female voice because it sounds a little weird. just suggesting it is, sometimes that's enough, sometimes you need more. I wish I could give you an answer, but there are some accents I'm good at, some I'm not so good at. I tend to be better than not, but it's a hard thing, and the knack, you're either born with it or you're not.
And some accents will always come easier to you, and some are never going to come to you. I don't care what happens, you can't get it through your head. I grew up in New York. And the one thing I love is people say, "Can you do a New York accent?" I feel like Henry Higgins.
Which one?
When I lived in Brooklyn. Yay, girl. Where? Where?
Queens area.
Queens is in Brooklyn, for God's sake.
I forget.
Somewhere in Brooklyn, anyway.
In
Brooklyn, for example, and I've actually had discussions with producers on this. They say, "We want a Brooklyn accent." "Which one? What do you mean, which one? Brooklyn?" "Excuse me. You got Flatbush, you know, where the people are from Flatbush, and they talk like this. They, honest to God, they do. You know, Barbara Streisand went to my high school. I'm telling you, when she talks like this, she means it. The people are like this." And then all of a sudden, you go to Bensonhurst. Well, Bensonhurst, you know, all the Goombas live in Bensonhurst. So you got the people talking like this. Different only, and it's, you know, we're all from Brooklyn, but you know, it's not the same people. So you have to, and those come fairly easily because I live there. But if it's something that you have to learn, there are people who are specific dialect coaches, and these people are brilliant at what they do. And if you know in advance that you're going to have to do something, you go to one, and you pay them whatever they want. They're that good, and you're going to need them that badly.